We listen to offers and about a number of different situations, and without going into any specifics, none of them were what I thought that would be consistent with the direction that we're going to head in. And you know, we're going to continue to try and get younger and get more diversified, and none of the proposals today would have accomplished what we would have wanted to accomplish.
I know there was some optimism at one point in the process. Was it ever close?
What do you mean, you know, there was some optimism?
Just from reports in other cities and things like that? There's like,
no, well,
was it ever close?
Was what ever close?
I deal with Volley Ride.
We listen to proposals beforehand, and I'm not going into specifics about any specific player, so you can do what you want with that, but none of them were adequate enough for any player that we had that we thought would move us ahead and put us in a position where we can start to look at long-term goals.
They've been termed great offers that you got, so I guess you're saying you did not get great offers?
I'm not going to go into specifics, and what some person may determine is a great offer. You know, there's been reports out of all kinds of different places about all kinds of things that have been completely untrue. So I would caution you guys about what comes out of different cities in terms of what was offered us, because for the most part, none of them are accurate.
There's been some reports that ownership was involved in this one and maybe limited your ability to make a deal. Is there any truth to that?
Ownership is involved in all kinds of decisions that we make. And when you're in situations like this at trade deadline day and draft, they're going to be involved as you vet situations and you evaluate situations like any other business. And it's not uncommon. In fact, it's encouraged, because you need everybody in alignment when you're doing these kinds of things, and you need everybody on the same page in terms of what the direction of the team is going to be. And to do that, you have to have communication.
So was there ever a case where you wanted to make a deal in this situation and the owner said no?
No.
Did you worry at all about making too much change? You know, you move Roberto, a core guy, you look at moving Ryan. Did that factor into the equation?
No. What factored into the equation was how we were going to try and comply and execute on a long-term vision. I said yesterday that our team is underperformed. When you're in a situation where your team is underperforming, you get more calls from all kinds of different people trying to explore all kinds of different situations. That's the way the business works. When we were in a position where we were achieving and living up to the expectations we had for the club, we were doing the same thing, trying to get players from teams that were vulnerable. And we knew that was going to happen today. We're very cautious because of that, and if it wasn't going to fit with our long-range plans about how to build this team back to the level that we expect, we weren't going to do it. And we didn't get anything today that we thought we could do that would do that.
The fact that there was a list and a fairly small list, did that kind of limit your ability?
I'm not talking about that, Farhan. I've since my time here, we've maintained the conversations with players. In any situation, remain private. They won't trust us if we go out and speak to the media about private conversations that we have with them. And so I'm not going to talk about that.
So was the hope and intent then to move them again in the summer?
You guys are making presumptions that are like, we'll get to the summer. We're going to try and get in the playoffs here, and we're going to try and do our best to get this team playing the way it should play. And that's our main focus now. We'll talk about the summer when the season's over.
Were you busy right to the end?
Yeah, right up to the end. We were busy, and we were listening to proposals and evaluating proposals you know, deciding whether they were worthwhile to pursue or not. And it's not unlike any other trade deadline day. You're either trying to acquire players, or you're disposing of players, or you're remaining neutral. And you remain neutral because there isn't something there that you think is really a good thing to do.
Did you have an equation for what you wanted back for a particular player?
We always have an idea of what we would like in return, but teams have all kinds of different mixes of players and prospects and picks and different things that they're prepared to put into play. And so oftentimes on trade deadline day, you'll get 20 different proposals from different teams that you have to evaluate and sift through.
Can you say how many teams you were seriously talking to today about a potential deal? Was it three or four? Was it?
Well, we talked to all kinds of teams about potential deals involving all kinds of different players.
So more than three or four?
Oh, yeah. Yeah. Okay, thanks.
Sympathize with him. I'm usually that guy asking the same question seven different times and getting Brian Burkers, whoever, mad at me.
I get the feeling Mr. Gillis wasn't going to tell anybody anything.
I just want to go back and show you that viz from practice today. 3 o'clock Eastern.
Now, this is important because you're a big hugger. You like to hug.
I do. I'm an affectionate guy. So Ryan Kesler finds out that he didn't get traded. He's not reciprocating here.
So you think he should drop his gloves and you know? Oh, there's a bit of a hug back.
Does that look like a real happy guy?
Yeah, just before he said beat it. Yeah.
Who knows? Hey, I mean, you know, we just heard Mike Gillis saying all sorts of stuff about presumptions and be careful what to read into things and who knows what. That's a very opaque situation right now in Vancouver. Who's running things? Mike Gillis, ownership.
Can that team get into the playoffs?
What does Ryan Kesler want? Look, as we just said, they've got inexperienced goaltending. Daniel Sedin's out for a while. Other than that, they're in great shape.
With Daniel Sedin out and they got Luongo's salary to play with, they didn't do anything. I thought they might add if they weren't going to start trading away.